transistor characteristics. Circuit diagram. Materials required: rheostat, ammeter, voltmeter, ammeter, battery, one-way key, transistor, breadboard, one-way key, battery, rheostat, and connecting wires. Procedure. Connect the positive terminal of the battery E1 to the lower end of the rheostat RH1. Negative terminal of the battery is connected to the other lower terminal of the rheostat through the key K1. The negative terminal of the voltmeter is connected to the key K1. The positive terminal of the voltmeter V1 is connected to the upper terminal of the rheostat RH1. Upper end of the rheostat RH1 is connected to the positive of the microammeter. Connect the lower end of the rheostat RH2 to the positive terminal of the cell E2. Negative terminal of the battery is connected to the other lower terminal of the rheostat through the key K2. Connect the negative terminal of the voltmeter V2 to the key K2. The positive terminal of the voltmeter is connected to the upper terminal of the rheostat RH2. The upper end of the rheostat RH2 is connected to the positive of milliammeter. Now, connect the negative terminal of the microammeter to the base B of the transistor. Emitter E of the transistor is connected to the negative terminal of the voltmeter V1. The collector of the transistor is connected to the negative terminal of milliammeter. Transistor specification: emitter, collector, base. Input characteristics. Connect the keys K1 and K2 using a connecting wire and insert the keys. The collector voltage VCE is kept constant by adjusting the rheostat RH2. Output voltage, input voltage, input current. Note the base voltage VBE from the voltmeter V1 and base current IB from the microammeter. Record the values in a tabular column. By keeping the collector voltage constant, the base voltage VBE is varied from 0 by adjusting the rheostat RH1. Note the base voltage VBE and base current IB. Record the values in the tabular column. Increase the base voltage using the rheostat RH1. Note the base voltage VBE and base current IB. Record the values in the tabular column. Again, increase the base voltage using the rheostat RH1. Note the base voltage VBE and base current IB. Record the values in the tabular column. Repeat the experiment by again increasing the base voltage. Plot a graph between base voltage VBE along x-axis and base current IB along y-axis for the constant collector voltage. Adjust the rheostat RH2 and increase the collector voltage VCE to a constant value. Note the base voltage VBE and base current IB. Record the values in the tabular column. By keeping the collector voltage constant, the base voltage VBE is varied from 0 by adjusting the rheostat RH1. Note the base voltage VBE and base current IB. Record the values in the tabular column. Increase the base voltage using the rheostat RH1. Note the base voltage VBE and base current IB. Record the values in the tabular column. Repeat the experiment by again increasing the base voltage. plot the VBE versus IB graph for the constant VCE. Adjust the rheostat RH2 and increase the collector voltage VCE to another constant value. Note the base voltage VBE and base current IB. Record the values in the tabular column. By keeping the collector voltage constant, the base voltage VBE is varied from 0 by adjusting the rheostat RH1. Note the base voltage VBE and base current IB. Record the values in the tabular column. Increase the base voltage using the rheostat RH1. Note the base voltage VBE and base current IB. Record the values in the tabular column. Repeat the experiment by again increasing the base voltage. Plot the VBE versus IB graph for the constant VCE. The graphs are called the input characteristics of the transistor. Output characteristics. The base current IB is kept constant by adjusting the rheostat RH1. Note the collector voltage VCE from the voltmeter V2 and collector current IC from the milliammeter. Record the values in a tabular column. By keeping the base current constant, the collector voltage VCE is increased by adjusting the rheostat RH2. Note the collector voltage VCE and collector current IC. Record the values in the tabular column. Increase the collector voltage VCE by adjusting the rheostat RH2. Note the collector voltage VCE and collector current IC. Record the values in the tabular column. Repeat the experiment by again increasing the collector voltage. Plot a graph between collector voltage VCE along x-axis and collector current IC along y-axis for the constant base current. Adjust the rheostat RH1 and increase the base current to another constant value. Note the collector voltage VCE and collector current IC. Record the values in the tabular column. By keeping the base current constant, the collector voltage VCE is increased by adjusting the rheostat RH2. Note the collector voltage VCE and collector current IC. Record the values in the tabular column. Increase the collector voltage VCE by adjusting the rheostat RH2. Note the collector voltage VCE and collector current IC. Record the values in the tabular column. Repeat the experiment by again increasing the collector voltage. Plot the VCE versus IC graph for the constant IB. Adjust the rheostat RH1 and increase the base current to another constant value. Note the collector voltage VCE and collector current IC. Record the values in the tabular column. By keeping the base current constant, the collector voltage VCE is increased by adjusting the rheostat RH2. Note the collector voltage VCE and collector current IC. Record the values in the tabular column. Increase the collector voltage VCE by adjusting the rheostat RH2. Note the collector voltage VCE and collector current IC. Record the values in the tabular column. Repeat the experiment by again increasing the collector voltage. Plot the VCE versus IC graph for the constant IB. These graphs are called the output characteristics of the transistor.